There are only 6 4-hour open high low close candles per day, and there are only 4 hour 1 open high low candles in each hour 4 candle. And in hour 1 candle there are only 4 15 minute open high low closes. These 3 4-hour candles are the most important ones for the intraday trading. The body of the candle generally tells the story. Wicks do the real damage. When weekly candle expands up, majority daily candles inside that weekly candle will also be expanding up. Or just to say, majority daily candles in that weekly candle as bullish closure above their open. In the same way, when the daily candle expand up, 4-hour candles inside the daily candle will also be expanding up. When the 4-hour candle expands up, 15 minute 1-hour candles inside this 4-hour candle will also be expanding up. Most of you guys already know this, but those are the ones who are not aware of this, please go through it. I also made a video about this, linked in the description. So now let's jump into the examples. A thick candle, or say a range candle, would print into the key level and sometimes below the actual high time frame key level. Then price ranges inside that thick candle in order to create a false hope to chase the momentum. When it finally breaks out of this range candle, breakout traders are gonna get suckered in. Traders in the low time frame who are not aware of the high time frame would generally have a bullish sentiment. This is a daily candle. When this daily candle shown with this blue arrow is printing and not closed yet, you can see on this right image, there will be a beginning of market maker sell model that's happening inside this daily candle. And we know that on daily time frame we had it a monthly key level, and monthly key level which produces daily candle expansions. So we know daily candle gonna reverse at this monthly key level. So here is market maker sell model, hourly market maker sell model happening after this previous day high ride. Here is the smart money reversal after this previous day high ride. On the right side of the curve, seeing this bounce, traders stuck in the low time frame, seeing the momentum candles happened before, will generally have a bullish sentiment here. This bounce validates their bullish stand even more. What happens next is their stop loss get hit. We can take an OTA entry here when price comes back up here and hold for previous day low, also to the equilibrium of daily range as a short term trade, because all our time frames are aligned now. We know the daily gonna reverse here at monthly, and we framed hourly market maker sell model aligned with this daily candle direction. You can see here there is a temporary low time frame discount area even in the high time frame premium. In this 1-hour market maker sell model, after riding the previous day high, we can frame a 5-minute market maker sell model in the hourly premium PDRS. In this hourly dealing range marked by these blue dots, here is the 1-minute market maker buy model after riding the hourly candle low. 50% of the candle is a high probability target, as this 1-minute market maker buy model is a counter trend trade and a very risky trade. You cannot aim to hold it for this candle high, this hourly candle high. You can frame a less risky ProTrend 5-minute market maker cell model at this hourly PDRA in the premium. They formed a range, low time frame range, 5-minute and 1-minute range, denoted by this letter A, B. Then they broke out of this range, turtle soup. You can sell here and aim for this candle low, as this is pro trend and aligned with high time frames. Let's take a bullish example now. This is 4-hour time frame. After weekly key level is hit, you can anticipate 4-hour candle expansions. And it has happened here after touching the weekly key level. You can see market printed a thick bearish candle into the key level. As I said, every candle is a range. After this 4-hour candle low ride, we can frame a setup. We can frame a 15-minute market maker buy model here confidently. As we know, weekly level produces 4-hour candle expansions. Hourly and 15-minute candles in this 4-hour candle will also obviously expand. Here is the 15-minute inversion FVG entry. Then here is breaker entry. 15-minute market maker buy model all the way up to the 4-hour candle range high. After this 4-hour bullish candle is closed, you can see a 4-hour order block is formed. When the next 4-hourly candle opens, you can anticipate it to wick down and expand up. As we know, 4-hour candle expansions happens on weekly key level. So after this new 4-hour candle got opened, it tapped into 4-hour OB and it took some internal liquidity, and we can anticipate 15-minute expansions on this 4-hour bullish OB. We can see on this right image, new 4-hour candle opened, took this internal liquidity and expanded to external range liquidity again. The blue dot here is the external range liquidity. 15-minute expansions after taking this internal liquidity to this external range liquidity. In this 4-hour candle, there are 4 hour 1 candles. It retraced to 50% equilibrium of previous 4-hour candle. This week, you see here, we zoomed into this week on the right side of the image. Here, same thing is happening. The same thing is repeating, which we discussed before. The 1-hour candle low is purged and it expanded up. In this week, there will be 1-minute candle expansions. This hourly bias to the upside is coming from 4-hour. We know that 4-hour candles are expanding up. This 4-hour candles order flow is sponsored by this weekly key level. We can anticipate previous 4-hour candle highs to be broken truly. We can go into low time frame and frame a bullish setup towards the 4-hour candle highs.